one of Time's 100 most influential people in the world, she's headlining the Coachella Music Festival, and her first album sold 138,000 copies in its first week. She's also the third most followed person on Instagram, the 11th most followed on Twitter, and her Facebook page has more than 30 million likes. Who are we talking about? The one and only Ariana Grande, of course. Born on June 26, 1993, in Boca Raton, Florida, this pop sensation has been taking the world by storm since she was in her teens. Before we make you green with envy by showing you Ariana's dreamy properties, make sure to like this video, subscribe to The Richest, and join our notification squad. Now let's get into how Ariana Grande spends her millions. Music and acting have been in Ariana's life for as long as we can remember. By the age of 8, she was performing with the Fort Lauderdale Children's Theater, playing roles in the likes of Annie and The Wizard of Oz. She also performed at a karaoke lounge on a cruise ship at this age, as well as spending some time with various orchestras. If that wasn't enough, Ariana also made her TV debut before she hit her teens. It's clear that performing in one way or another has always been in her blood, but this was just the very beginning for this star. At the age of 13, Ariana decided for sure that she wanted to enter the music industry. She decided that she wanted to make an R&B album, but her manager quickly shot her down by asking her who would really be buying music of that genre created by someone so young. Although her manager might have had a point at the time, it only served as motivation for Ariana, who was determined to do whatever she could to achieve her goals. But before she broke into the musical world, Ariana started her career on TV. You'll probably recognize her for her role as Kat Valentine on Nickelodeon's hit TV show, Victorious. The popular show was the starting point for Ariana's huge income and reportedly earned her $9,000 per episode for the first series. Ariana's character was lovable and the series was watched by millions, so the high salary was well-deserved. Starring in Victorious gave Ariana the nationwide recognition that she needed to launch a music career, and she started uploading covers of songs to YouTube. Soon after, she was offered a contract by Monty Lipman, CEO of Republic Records. We might all know Ariana's music now for being sassy, catchy, and full of amazing lyrics, but she wasn't too happy with the first song that she released. Called Put Your Hearts Up, it was a bubblegum pink pop song that she claimed she wasn't interested in producing again. However, it seems the world disagreed because it was certified gold before not too long. While you might have thought that this pop star's time in front of the camera was over by now, Ariana still had some time left to practice her acting as well as singing. Three Victorious soundtracks were released featuring Ariana, and a spin-off of the series called Sam and Cat was produced by Nickelodeon. Although it was successful and drew in a lot of viewers again, the show was dropped after 36 episodes. But we're sure it still earned Ariana a good amount of cash, and it must have boosted her bank account quite a bit. But now let's focus on the real reason why Ariana is on the top of the world today, her music. She released her first studio album called Yours Truly in 2013. Obviously, it did well with a debut number one spot on the US Billboard 200 albums chart. It also sold 138,000 copies in its first week and gave her the income to match. Now that's definitely something to shout about. But that was just the beginning of this exponential growth into fame and fortune that she sits upon today. In 2013, she won the award for New Artist of the Year at the American Music Awards, and later in the year, she also received the Breakthrough Artist of the Year Award from the Music Business Association. Ariana's name was taking off, and with it, a new direction into music. We're sure you can predict what happened next. Ariana's fame grew larger before eventually almost taking over the world. Her second album called My Everything debuted at the top of the Billboard 200 and sold 169,000 copies in its first week. It debuted at the top spot in Australia and Canada and also peaked in the top 10 of 20 different countries around the world. Following the release of some incredibly catchy singles, Ariana went on the honeymoon tour. She earned $40 million for singing her songs in a variety of different countries to an audience just begging her to release more tracks. After this came More Music and the Dangerous Woman Tour, another which brought in more money than we'd ever think was possible. The tour grossed $71 million and certified Ariana as one of the best performers of our generation. In fact, the album quickly reached the top spot on the UK album chart, as well as Australia, Brazil, Italy, Ireland, New Zealand, Spain, and Taiwan. In October 2016, it was certified platinum. So by now, Ariana was taking home enough dollars to never need to work another day in her life. But singing and acting isn't the only way that she's been making money. Ariana is known for her cool fashion sense, and teens around the world look to her for style inspiration. So it came as no surprise when she launched a 20-piece clothing collection with fashion brand Lipsy. While the outfits themselves might not have been too high a price tag, we're sure the collaboration brought in a lot of money for Ariana to store away in her bank account. And that's not her only fashion-based collaboration. She's also a brand ambassador for sneaker brand Reebok. She created a perfume which has reportedly made upwards of $150 million in sales, and she also earns a lot of bucks from the variety of merchandise that can be bought on all of her tours. And if that wasn't enough, she also worked with makeup brand MAC in January 2016 to release a collection which donated 10% of proceeds to the MAC AIDS Fund. Ariana cares a lot about helping people in the world, but we'll come into that a bit later. Ariana started working on her fourth album, Sweetener, back in 2016, but didn't release the first single called No Tears Left to Cry until April 2018. Since then, she's released a stream of hits like God is a Woman, Thank You Next, and Seven Rings. You're probably familiar with all of them, and we imagine the lyrics to at least one of these hits will probably be stuck in your head for the rest of this video. Thank You Next was certified platinum in the United States and became the most watched music video on YouTube within 24 hours of release. On Spotify, the song became the most streamed song by a female artist in a single 24-hour period, and also the fastest song in history to reach 100 million streams. In late 2018, Ariana released the Ariana Grande Dangerous Woman Diaries on YouTube Premium. It's probably her most recent new stream of income, and it's all come together to give her the estimated net worth of $50 million that she has today. So, now we've covered all of the revenue streams that Ariana's using to boost her bank account, which means it's time to get into the fun part, where she's spending all of these hard-earned dollars. Let's start with her property. For most of us, owning a house is a distant dream in the future, if we can scrape together enough dollars to do so. House hunting in New York, where Ariana lives, is also another source of stress that many people choose to avoid. But for Ariana, it's a whole other story. Shortly after she got engaged to Pete Davidson in 2018, Ariana started house hunting. With an income like hers, the main source of stress was finding somewhere with privacy and all of the decorative features that she required. However, it didn't seem to take her too long to find the perfect property. The pair scraped a few pennies together and bought themselves an insane 4,000-square-foot apartment in Chelsea. It reportedly set them back around $16 million. Inside, you'll find 5 bedrooms, 4.5 bathrooms, and views of the Empire State Building to gaze at while eating breakfast together in the morning. But this wasn't any standard Manhattan apartment. Inside the complex, there's also a private 12-seat IMAX theater, a 75-foot indoor pool, a wellness floor with a private spa, steam room, sauna, and plunge pool, a fitness center, and a private party space. Basically, if Ariana wanted to stay inside her apartment for a few days without venturing outside, she'd never get bored. After Ariana and Pete broke up, no one was certain what would become of their house together. But luckily, that's not the only place that Ariana owns. She also has a house in California featuring 6,226 square feet of space, 5 bedrooms, and 5.5 bathrooms. It includes stunning views of the Hollywood Hills and an outdoor pool and adjoining hot tub that overlooks downtown LA. It's the perfect place to chill out after a busy day of performing. Inside the house, you'll find marble floors, stone gate rails, and spotlights in the ceilings. Ariana can also relax on the outdoor seating area with her friends in the evenings. And let's not forget the huge walk-in closet filled with designer clothes in the master bedroom. When it comes to cars, Ariana hasn't splashed out perhaps as much as many other celebrities choose to. It seems she'd rather spend her money on properties rather than vehicles to park outside of them. But that doesn't mean that she doesn't have some cool rides to her name. Ariana's most famous car is probably her Snow White Range Rover, which could be worth up to $186,000. And that's before any extra modifications or upgrades. She also drives a silver Mercedes SL class convertible, which has a starting price tag of just under $100,000, and a black Cadillac Escalade, which starts at $75,000. So while she might not be driving around in a Ferrari or a Lamborghini, it's clear that Ariana still has expensive taste when it comes to choosing her cars. And that's not the only way that Ariana gets around. She's also been spotted climbing into a private jet on her Instagram, suggesting that her need for privacy and luxury extends to above the ground, too. And in possibly the most Ariana Grande stunt ever, she was pictured stepping onto her jet in 6-inch stiletto heels. How's that for a dangerous woman move? We're not sure if she owns the jet or whether she just rents it, but it's pretty impressive either way. Before we move on to all of the things Ariana's filling her house with, we need to mention maybe her cutest purchases. And by that, we mean her pets. We have to start off by telling you that Ariana's 9 dogs were all rescue dogs, so if she paid anything at all to take them home, it was probably very minimal. But 9 dogs adds up when you take everything from food and water to vet bills and accessories into account. We all thought that Ariana looked like a dog lover, and so we're not surprised to hear that she has a whole host of wagging tails waiting to greet her when she gets home. Ariana's dog squad consists of Fox, Pignoli, Ophelia, Toulouse, Coco, Sirius, Cinnamon, Strauss, and Lafayette. And when it comes to breeds, she's not picky. There are big dogs, small dogs, mixed breeds, and mutts. Not only has she given all of these pets a luxurious forever home that they so desperately needed, but she's also paving the way for the adopt, don't shop movement. And now let's take a minute to talk about Ariana's probably most recognizable feature, her ponytail. She's known for the iconic hairstyle, and there are plenty of imitation extensions that can be bought online to look like this musical queen, but wearing her hair in this style can come at a high cost. Keeping the hair tied up all of the time means it's liable to breaking, splitting, and losing some of its natural bounce. So it's only appropriate that Ariana uses a variety of expensive hair products to keep her ponytail looking sleek as ever. She started wearing it in this style back in 2014 and claimed she did so because her hair was so damaged by bleach that it was the only style that hid the broken strands. Luckily, she's got enough money in the bank to sort it out nowadays. Along with being known for her ponytail, Ariana's also known for splashing out on tattoos. On January 29, 2019, Ariana revealed a new tattoo to celebrate the release of her song, 7 Rings. Originally posted to Instagram, Ariana explained that the tattoo, which was done in Japanese kanji characters, meant the same as the song title. Unfortunately, it actually translated roughly to barbecue grill. Luckily, all of her other tattoos have been more successful. She has a large amount, 20 in fact, and they include one of her favorite Pokemon, a crescent moon and stars, more Japanese characters, and a heart. Good tattoos don't come cheap, so in total, Ariana's most likely spent a small fortune on her ink. Remember when we said earlier that we'd go back to talking about how Ariana is determined to help people across the world? Well, it's finally time to astound you with just how much charity work this star has done. Ariana started raising money for charity at the age of 10, and it's something she's continued to devote time and money to, despite her busy touring schedule. She's taken part in a campaign to end online bullying, raised money for Stand Up to Cancer, and urged fans to stop supporting SeaWorld and became a vegan. As noted earlier, she's worked to help people affected by HIV and AIDS, and she's helped homeless and LGBT youths. If that wasn't enough, Ariana has raised funds for orphan children in Malawi. We must mention her One Love Manchester concert, which reportedly raised $23 million after a terrible tragedy occurred at her concert only a few weeks previous. It seems that Ariana's kept charity work a consistent part of her life since a young age, and it just works to remind us of what a wonderful person she is. That's all for how Ariana Grande spends her millions. What do you think of this pop star's spending habits? Did you know she had this many pets? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.